Hello, my beautiful darlings, and welcome to another Bedroom Guru. And it's your turn now, fire signs, Leo, Saturn, Aries. What has 2022 got in store for you?
Turn the spotlight on our studio audience as we hand over to our psychic medium, Nikki Allen.
Okay, let's have a little look. We're going to be using the Fairy Tarot cards for you, my little darlings. We're going to be doing Rider Waite clarifiers and, as a little angel bonus, Angels of Light, Diana Cooper, just to give you an additional message for the year. So I'm going to do a very minute version of a gypsy spread. Remember, even though I'm doing this as the new year for 2022, if you have seen this, or you see this in a couple of years' time, your soul's meant to see it. And remember, this is a general reading for fire signs. And if you are even a cross watcher, you could be watching because your partner or someone dear to you is a fire sign. Have a little snoop to see what their year's like. Wow, at the moment, it's huge, my little fiery signs, full of action, wands in the tarot. You are the go-getters. You can be quite fiery when you need to be. However, you do like to work things out, be very diplomatic. At the moment, you've got two major arcanas that have just been listed. Wow, that's incredible. I will tell you in a minute, my lovelies. And a life experience could have been tainted by a Virgo, because we do have the Virgo card coming up here. Right, okay, we have that one come up. It's a little pitty-pattering of my little teddy bear and my little Mia Moo coming in to see what's going on. Right, keep going, keep going, keep going. Wow, okay, okay. Wow, you got three major arcana cards. Remember, they're the trump cards. They hold the most important part of the pack. Okay, Airs, so let me just do this last card for you and then we can get the narrative and see what we're doing. You're kind of recovering from something here, Aries. Air signs. I did Aries before. It's Leo Sagittarius. Oh, that's okay. My little air signs. Oh. Okay, you're looking like you're pulling back a bit after a bit of a tower experience, my fire signs. Call you my little fieries. One more so we can get the narrative for your reading. One more, please, my little darlings up in the spirit world, the ether, whoever influences me to pull these cards for these beautiful fire signs. Thank you. Oh, you've got an extra one. Oh, you've got an extra one, you cheekies. Okay, my lovelies. Funny enough, none of your wand signs have come up. None of your fire signs have come up here. But let's have a little look and see how we go. Okay, now your first card is life experience, which is the tower card. Do you remember I say this is like Daryl from The Walking Dead? And you got the tower moment. So something is kind of turned up on its heels. I feel like this is more... this feels like this has happened previously. So this has happened in the run up to Christmas or the last 3 or 4 months of last year. There's been a tower moment. This could be a loss. It could be you've lost your job. It could be a life circumstance that's completely turned you on your ass. Okay. The reason I feel this is in the present is because you've got the Virgo Hermit card coming in here, which has made you kind of withdraw a bit and have a little look at what's going on in your life. You could be withdrawing spiritually, emotionally, physically from any situation. So it's kind of like you've had a big change in your life and you're kind of thinking, woof, I need to have a look at this and see where I need to go from this, okay? It could be a change that you've had no control over and you're kind of like, have been shot to pieces and you've had to withdraw, rest and get yourself, you know, kind of all together, collect yourself so that you can get on with this new change in your life. But it has been a bit of a nightmare. Some of you, it may benefit you, but we'll find out what happens this year for you and how it's actually changed you, okay? We will do clarifiers on these, but it feels like you're just reeling a bit, or you've like come back into yourself to think of the, what plan, what should I do next in respect of this? Because it's kind of, you know, turned me on my arse, basically. Okay, so what's happened is, either towards the end of last year or even the beginning of this year, you're going to make a plan that you're going to start trying to get others involved. The Three of Pentacles is to do with work, creative solutions, anything to do with, like, you know, earth type needs, such as bills, payments, finance, home, security, money, work. Okay, so this has been highlighted twice. So I do feel that this turn of events has affected your home life or your finance or your security. Okay, it's turned you around a bit and you're like, oh my God, how am I going to go on from this? All right, but don't panic. Do not panic. We will continue and look at the cards and see what happens. So the Three of Autumn is about collaboration. It's a card of perhaps reaching out and speaking with people that know their field, know how they can help you, or it's going into business partnership, or it's collaborating with people to help you get towards your creative or financial desires. Okay, so if you're thinking about reaching out, branching out, bringing someone else on board, doing something new with somebody, this is the card to say, yes, you will be going for this and it will be successful. If that's your situation, go for it, because it's going to reap you really good dividends. Okay, so that's brilliant, because that's collaboration, adding someone that, you know, adding someone else to your plans. That's absolutely perfect. Now, this is perfect, right? Because this is your guarantee here, Fieries. Okay, this is your guarantee. The Queen of Autumn has got it smashed, baby. She's basically ascertained everything she's worked towards. So if you had the Tower moment last year, it could even have just happened. Okay, we all have different timescales here, but what I'm telling you is, do not give up, do not panic, because this is telling you that you're going to get exactly what you want and need from this situation. The situation has changed for the better. It may not feel like that the time being, but it really is going to reap you rewards. The Queen of Pentacles, she sits on the throne. She's surrounded by abundance and luxury. She's got everything she's aspired to. She's got a power staff there. She's basically saying, I've done it, I've got it. It's all in the bag. I've got everybody around me that I need that's working for me, helping me, creatively bringing me to my end means. It's literally one short from the Queen and from the King, sorry. So, you know, she's almost in a situation where she can now be generous with her time and money, a situation, because she's got it sussed. So this is saying, whatever has happened, whatever has set you back, trust yourself. I'm seeing October for this. Autumn obviously comes up as a relevance as well. So I'm feeling that by September, you're going to think, I've smashed this. This is really, really good. Okay. Look out for 11s for you as well, Fieries. I keep seeing the number 11. Could be the 11th of September that you think, wow, I can't believe this, and make a note of it. Or the fact that literally new beginnings are afoot, 11-11. Remember, this is the year of new beginnings. 2022 is the year of new beginnings. So you're going to be finding that all of this change that perhaps you might not have wanted to change, or things that have happened in your life that have turned you upside down, really are pointing in the right direction. When things happen that change your life, change your perspective, it's always a universe either getting rid of something that you're too weak to get rid of, or they're saying, right, enough of this, because we need to work towards this now. Okay, so know that you're going to be getting to exactly where you need to get to with this card, whatever it's to do with. But as I say, in respect of home, money, security, finance, work, it's all to do with that, because the Pentacles reign on both corners of this reading. Okay, you need though to, rather than sit and feel sorry for yourself, whatever's happened, I know it may seem like a bit of hard work, but discipline is needed now, the Fieries. Okay, you're going to need to get disciplined. So you need to kind of get almost a leadership role on what your plans are. Make plans of what you want to achieve. Remember, I've just done the video on that on the 1st of January. You're also going to be looking at perhaps making plans of who to bring on board, how you're going to bring that on board, how you're going to work that through, if you're going to be having new business partners or bringing people in with what you want to achieve, okay? So this is all about, don't feel sorry for yourself, don't sit back and have this self-pity party going on. You need to be looking at, how can I grab hold of this and make it work for me? So there may be a bit of work coming in that you have to kind of get grounded, and you have to really kind of get your head down and work a bit hard for what you want this year, Fieries, but trust me when I tell you, it is all worth it. Now the problem is, and do you know what, this is, I'm sure this has been highlighted in the other three signs, at least the first two I know, but you've got to believe in yourself. The Eight of Winter is basically self-fulfilling prophecies. It's doubt, it's worry, it's, can I really do this? Can I really get what I want out of life? Can I do it? It's like in the tarot, she's blindfolded, and she's quite happy with that blindfold on. She doesn't want to see the reality because she'd have to deal with it. So she'd rather be thinking and allowing her mind to, like the monkeys in her mind, to give her this self-fulfilling prophecy of the worst possible scenario. Get out of your heads, okay? You need to get out of your heads, lose the emotion around this situation, and start thinking, how can I work on this? How can I discipline myself? What do I need to do to get to this stage of contentment, abundance, and everything is sweet as a nut by September? So there is a bit of work, and there is a bit of getting out of your head. Okay, believe in yourself. Aim higher than you think that you can. Always aim higher. Okay? And then there is basically the five of cups or the five of summer. Okay? And this is about not thinking about the things you've lost. So do you know, we've got these first cards which I said about the tower moment. Something may have happened. You could have lost your job, lost a person, lost a relationship, whatever it is that suddenly affected your financial, work, creative endeavors. That's a new ethics word. Okay, so whatever's happened, don't stay stuck in the past on what could have been, what would have been, what you've lost, what we haven't got anymore. Come on, Fieries, you're better than that. You know, this card is about looking at what is behind you or what is in front of you. In the card, he's missing the two cups behind him going, hello, we're going to give you everything you need. Emotion, finance, support, home, security, new job, new business partners. But you're too bothered on looking what happened before. So there's an extra bonus card there to tell you to let go of whatever it is that happened. Let go of it. Grab hold of yourself after you've had this rest and decide which way you're going to go forwards, and start going for it. Okay, tell me about the tower moment, please. Tell me about the tower moment. I want to do a clarify on the life experience card, the tower moment with Daryl. I love it though, because it's Glastonbury Tour as the tower. How cool is that? Tell me about the tower. Leo, Sag, Aries. Eventually it'll come out. Patience is a virtue and all that. There we go, thank you. Oh my Christ, you couldn't make it up. You couldn't make it up. You've got the death card, right? That is one of the most positive cards in the deck. People don't think it is, right? But it is, because it means new beginnings, a new era. It is completely perfect for 2022. And basically it is backing up this tower moment. There is nothing that can be changed, nothing that can be gleaned from whatever this has happened in the past or is happening now. Okay, the death card is telling you to not resist, just let go and allow this new era and this new thing to come in. Look, the death card is even facing towards the tower. Face it head on, take it for what it is, take what you need from it, throw the rest away and accept this new challenge. You are being a bit stubborn. There is a bit of stubbornness in fire signs, but what I will say is that your stubbornness is going to delay this little puppy coming your way. Just saying. Anything more for the tower? Some of you have done good though, because the hermit, you've withdrawn intentionally. Some of you may have just withdrawn into a little rabbit hole of your own volition. But really, the hermit for me, the positive of the hermit card is for you to like kind of have a look and you know, re-evaluate everything rather than crawling to a duvet and ignore the world. There's two different types of the hermit. Okay, I've just asked about the hermit because obviously you've taken some time out to embrace what's taken place and all that kind of stuff. And what I'm seeing is here with the temperance is everything is divinely timed. Everything should have happened as it had. Everything is going to happen as it should now, okay? You've just got to be patient. Everything is in perfect balance. You've got the higher forces helping. You've got the lower forces helping. Emotionally, you've got one foot dipped in the water, which is calm, saying emotionally, I'm getting my head around this. I need to be patient. I know I have to wait for divine timing, knowing that if I wait, eventually I'll be along this path and the sun will rise and I will get everything that I need. Be patient, okay? But don't be stubborn. This is about going with the flow, Fieries. You know, you've got to really pull back and go with the flow. Right, tell me about the Emperor, please. Tell me about the Emperor. This is the card about being disciplined, you know, for you to increase your success and to improve your situation. This is all about you, like, getting people to follow you. Listen, yeah, look, you've got loads of options, it says, for the Emperor, okay? Loads of options. What shall I do? Shall I start a new business? Shall I carry on the old business? Shall I bring someone on board? Shall I just bin it all and start something anew? Shall I move home? Shall I carry on paying for that? Or shall I get rid of it and start afresh? This is all different options. And this is why the Hermit is above it, right? Because, and Temperance, because this has all got to be done, patiently done. So we don't want any knee-jerk reactions to your situation, okay? Because if you do, you could potentially end up picking the wrong cup. Look, you've got one with a snake hanging out there. Okay, all of these, like, there's a victory one there. They've all got different qualities, these cups. You've got to be very mindful what you want to pick to secure this new future for yourself. And don't do it out of impatience, stubbornness, or revenge, or, you know, whatever it is. You can't make any decisions out of emotion or ill-felt feelings or anything like that. This needs to be very much thought of. Withdraw. Have a look at how you're going to take forward your plans. And those plans, bloody perfect. Gemini is here with the Lovers. And so this is telling me that rather than talking about, we're not talking about relationships in this reading, this is more about practical matters. So this is about by taking the steps to have the right people with you, going towards your creative skills, you can have the right people that have got your back, that mutually respect you, that support you and want to be your rock for you while you get yourself back on track and sort everything out you need to financially, home-wise, security, whatever it is. Okay, so the balance is there. It's, you've got people that have got your back and you will attract those as well. The more you make the wiser decisions and take the wiser options, the more you're going to be very, very happy and have lots of happy, positive people around you. It's all good. It's just you grabbing hold of it, moving forward and taking this challenge on with verve, with energy, with self-belief. Because if you don't do that, if you stay stuck with this lack of self-belief and the fact it's all going to go wrong, it will. Okay, tell me about the Five of Summer, please. I'm joined with the Eight of Winter. King of Cups, emotional balance, well-being. Everything's in sync, everything is calm, everything as it should be. So with this, we're looking again, I'm thinking some of you may start experiencing the change July, August time, but as we definitely come into our autumnal months, you're gonna have this element of, you know, we've got a couple of Pisces here. Pisces, Cancer and Scorpio with the Cups. But what I will say, yeah, and what I will say is that you are actually gonna be a lot happier despite this challenge, upset, life change, despite you having to fight to get back to where you are, whatever situation it is, you are going to actually sit back and go, I've achieved everything I need. You're going to be emotionally balanced, you're going to have everything as it should be, and you're going to feel calm, and you've got it in the bag with the King of Cups. He's just basically a really calm, thoughtful, and you might feel a bit that you want to be more romantic, a bit more childlike in your love. You're just going to feel so much better towards the end of the year. This may come sooner. Remember that, all right? This isn't just divinely, there's divine timing. So if you're further ahead, if you are grabbing hold of the Emperor energy and you aren't allowing yourself to have all this blindfolded business, then you are going to smash it. Okay, you really are going to do well, but there's just a bit of a fight, bit of a struggle, bit of hard work, bit of grind put in there for you to achieve. I know that's upside down. For you to achieve, must be psychic, what you want, okay? Any further messages to back up this? Stand by your beliefs. Stand by your principles. Don't sacrifice yourself. Don't do anything you don't want to do. Don't do anything that's going to compromise your happiness, your home, your security. Act prudently, plan it strategically, and know that also everything is divinely timed and will happen when it's supposed to. Be patient. Thank you. Anything more? Anyway, fairies. Anything more at all for Leo, Sag, Aries? Oh, I didn't see that. That's freaky. Couldn't make this shit up if you tried. Excuse my plodding, bleeding French. Number one. Need I say more? Grab hold of whatever it is that's pulled you back. Have a look at it and find your way forward on how you can get on with this through either leadership skills or self-discipline. That's come up now. What are the odds of that? If you don't do this, you are not going to get all of the happy endings. I kid you not. This is incredible because the promise is, look what's come up next to the King of Cups. You couldn't make it up if you tried. By your actions, digging in deep and going with the flow of this massive change, wherever it is that's taken place, you are going to, one, not only heighten relationships you're in, it's going to make family life, love life, relationships around you blessed, balanced, emotionally secure, emotionally balanced. Everything. Look, you've got the Queen and the King of Cups together. You really are going to make this. If you're struggling, trust me, you're going to get there. Why do I know that? Because the last card that fell out is the ultimate card of home and security. And it's your card, fieries. Wands. The Four of Wands, representing the four walls of the home. Happiness in family, love, life, security, finance, marriage, everything that you could possibly aspire to, that the Tower might have turned up over on its ass, you will accomplish by September. By this time next year, you'll look back and think it was a bit tough to begin with. I had to get over myself, but you know what? I did get a grip. I didn't feel sorry for myself. I turned into an emperor and I made the right options. Where's that gone? Can't believe I can find it now. I made the right options. Wherever that options card's gone. I made the right options. I trusted that everything would be timed as it should be. I wasn't stubborn. I didn't keep looking back at all everything that had happened. I stayed focused. I accepted that this was the end of that particular era and I had to move on. And now I've got exactly what I want. And if the Tower moment hadn't have happened, I would never be in this space where I am now. Complete happiness, abundance, balance. And equilibrium, love, calm, tranquility, and all stresses over in the family, home, or environment. So, I'm not going to repeat all that again because I sound too bossy, but you know what you've got to do, fieries, okay? Now, I'm just going to ask for an angel message for you. These cards, I've had these for donkey's years, and I only just found them a little while ago when I was going through my tarot drawer. And I love them. They give such good advice. Let's see what they've got for you. Leo, Sag, Aries. Leo, Sag, Aries. Thank you. First one, when this is blank, it means that whatever you want to aspire to, whatever you want to dream of, write it out and create your own. It's like, you know, like blank canvas, starting a blank canvas, which is ridiculous. This is exactly what this is all about. You've been given a blank canvas. Fill it with what you want, but choose carefully and take your time. That's just a bonus. See if there's any words they want to say. Any words for Leo, Sag, Aries, please. It's good, isn't it? Just don't be a victim, for God's sake. That's kind of out, but it's not. If you can bring it back to me again, please. Leo, Sag, Aries. Be patient with people as well. Imagination. Thoughts are the building bricks of life, for everything begins with a thought. Add creativity to thoughts and you have imagination. Every castle starts as a castle in the air. This image is then grounded by architects and builders. The angels are inviting you to use the power of your creative imagination to expand your horizons and picture the life you want. When you hold a vision, the angels see the clarity of your intention and open doors to help you. The angel wisdom guides you to decide your desired outcomes. Be certain that you have. This is what I was about to say. Do you know what I just said earlier? Make sure it's all from the greater good. Do you know what I mean? Be certain that you have the purest intention of what you want to achieve. Then image your dreams and start the process of creation. And the affirmation is, I picture positive outcomes for the highest good. Couldn't make it up, because this is basically the creativity and what you want to create yourself. This is why it's left blank. And then it's talking about you using your creativity, your imagination to create reality. And that's what all these cards are all about. It's you recreating this new phase of life that's coming in or has already come in, and you're reeling from it at the moment. But this is the best thing that's happened, because to be honest with you, if it stayed with it or the tower moment would have happened, you'd still be plodding along, not getting anywhere anytime soon. So it's good stuff coming. Take this all on board. Make notes if you wish. Remember, as I said, 2022 is the year of new beginnings. And so it's almost like it's, you know, it's supporting you. And to end this card on your suit, the Wands, fiery, fiery Wands. You've got it in the bag. Be strong. Get your head down and go for it. I hope you've loved the predictions for the year 2022. Thank you again to all my subscribers that are joining every day. I really hope you're enjoying the channel. And thank you to all the people that are still here with me. I do really appreciate it. Until the next time, God bless. And remember, think good things, feel good things, and do good things. Take care now. Bye.